Prison Earth is a fairly large place. It has hundreds of different prison cells and billions of prisoners. Some of the prison cells are pretty large, some are much smaller. Some are fairly nice, others are horrible. I was born in jail cell R, which isn't the worst cell in the prison, but many would argue that it's not the best one either. Back in the 90s, when I was growing up, cell R was actually considered to be a pretty dangerous place. Because of that, my father worked hard to move my family and me to cell U, which was considered to be a much better cell at the time. But it wasn't easy to make the move from cell R to cell U, or to go anywhere, in fact. You can't just move freely from one prison cell to another. All prison cells have very strict rules about who can enter and exit each cell and for how long. The walls between each prison cell are strictly patrolled by guards, and it's almost impossible to leave your own cell without granted permission. To be granted permission to leave your cell, you first need to get a small booklet that has your details written on it. It has your name, your date of birth, your inmate number, where you were born, and some other information. Most prisoners can leave their cells by showing this booklet to the guards, but some cannot. For most prisoners, getting out of their own jail cell is the easy part, though. The hard part is entering into a new cell. You see, there is no free or common area in the prison. The entire prison is strictly divided into jail cells, and each cell has its own rules that you have to follow. The booklet that I told you about dictates which cells you can enter and for how long. Since some jail cells are better than others, this means that some prisoners are more privileged than others. In some jail cells, people slave for livable wages and have access to healthcare and education. In other cells, a lot of people suffer. They slave in awful conditions and barely earn enough to eat. If you're born in a good jail cell, like the ones in Area E or Area A, you might be quite lucky. Not only because you'll have access to healthcare and some good services, but also because you can leave your jail cell and temporarily enter many other cells just by showing your booklet to the guards. But if you're born in one of the bad prison cells, you're quite unlucky because it will be very difficult for you to leave or to improve that cell. Most likely, you'll be very poor and the prison guards won't let you into the good cells without additional special permission. To get additional special permission, it can be very difficult. Not only do you need to show the guards your booklet, but you also need to show them a special stamp called a visa that you can only get from the authorities. To get this stamp, you either have to have a lot of money or you have to sign into a contract to be a devoted slave for a company in the good jail cell. But that will only happen if you're very skilled. Sometimes you can also perform a ritual called marriage with someone from that jail cell. Once you have the documents and the stamp, the guards can still refuse you entry into their cell if they feel like it. And if you're poor, there's a good chance that you'll get denied. The funny part is that most prisoners don't even realize that they're locked up. Most prisoners don't even try to go into a neighboring cell for longer than they're allowed to. Most don't question the guards or the other prisoners. They just do what they've always done. They work, work, work. They slave their lives away in their designated jail cells. And they only take vacations when they're allowed, only for as long as they're allowed. They might be numb to this prison. They might be quietly existing, working in the system, perhaps drinking, smoking, or taking pills to cope with the lack of meaning in their imprisoned existence. But I hope you're not like that. I hope you question and take a step outside, at least with your own mind.